everyone, my name is Colleen and I have a 1.5-year-old son and I'm gonna give you an update on him even though no one asked for it. I know I do these videos all the time and I know you're probably sick of them, but I really like doing them. I like going back and watching them and seeing how much my son has grown. I also like watching these videos of other moms on YouTube. So if this is not something that interests you, you don't have to watch it, but for those of you who wanna stick around and see what my 1.5-year-old is up to these days, hi, welcome. This is gonna be such a cute video. I feel like I just did an update video on him recently, but who cares? He's 1.5 today. Hooray! My little boy is growing up. It's so wild. I cannot believe he's 1.5 already. This is so crazy. For those of you who live in the mom world, he is 18 months. For those of you who live in the normal world, he's 1.5. He is the coolest little kid in the world. So let's get into the video. My son Flynn is the coolest little guy in the whole world. No offense to all the other cute little boys out there, but I think mine's pretty much the best. He is talking a lot. So he is trying really hard to talk to us in full sentences, but he doesn't make much sense. He mostly just babbles.
Which one? You want that one? Okay.
Yes, I agree. He says so many words, and he's just now starting to put words together. So he's starting to do little sentences now. So he'll say, where's Dada? Where's Mama?
Dada.
Where's Dada?
Google. Oh, Google. Oh, Google.
Or he'll see our dog Moose eating food. He calls food Nana. So he'll go, Moo Moo Nana, which is Moose eating food. So he's starting to kind of put words together and make his own little sentences, and it's so cute. His newest thing that he does all the time is he goes, oh no!
Oh no!
Oh no! And he goes, oh wow!
Wow.
Wow. Those are my two favorites right now. If you've watched some of my update videos on my kid in the last 6 months, you would know that he's very obsessed with cars or anything with wheels. He calls them dar-dars.
Oh, dar-dar.
He is still very much obsessed with dar-dars. Anything with wheels, he is just absolutely in love with, loses his mind over. He loves trucks and bulldozers and dump trucks and garbage trucks and fire engines and airplanes and little cars and motorcycles. Like anything that has a wheel, my son will lose his mind over. Like if he hears an airplane, he says bubba for airplane. I don't know why, but he says bubba. And if he hears or sees an airplane in the sky, he goes bubba. Like he gets so excited. So our house is mostly just car toys, airplane toys, truck toys. That is the only thing my son wants to play with, and it's the thing that he loves more than anything else in this entire universe. My son loves cars. He has 16 teeth. RIP my nipples. Yes, I still breastfeed. We'll get to that later. He has 16 freaking teeth. I think that's how many. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Is that a lot for a 1.5-year-old, or is that normal? I don't know. I feel like he was always really ahead in his teeth getting. He always gets a tooth at the beginning stage that you can possibly get a tooth. He currently has 16 teeth and
wow.
That's a lot of teeth. We're starting to try to teach him things more, which has been really fun. So we teach him all the different body parts. So right now he knows his belly button, nose, eyes, ears, mouth, head, hands, and feet. And he loves to point to them and talk about them. He also somehow knows poo-poo, because if you're asking him about his body parts and you say, where's your poo-poo? I thought the first time I asked him that, he would point to his butt, but he actually just started grunting and trying to push out a poop. So now we know he's kind of constipated or needs to go poop. We go, where's your poo-poo? And he'll literally push out a turd. Where's your poo-poo? Where's your mouth?
Mom.
Yeah, where's your nose? Yeah. Where's your head? Where's your poo-poo? Where's your poo-poo? Where's your poo-poo, Flynn? So that's fun. He also knows a lot of different animals and the sounds that they make. So he knows duck, horse, cow, chicken, dog, cat, tiger, dinosaur. He knows a bunch of different animals and he knows their sounds. So if you say, what does the kitty say? He goes meow, meow, meow. That was really surprising the day we found out that he knew every sound that animals made, because we didn't teach him that. I mean, we read him stories and books and we talk about it, but we weren't like actively trying to get him to learn those things. He just picked them up. I think that's been one of the most surprising things as a mom, is realizing that he is just learning so much constantly, even when I don't realize he is. He's listening to us talk all the time. He's learning from us all the time. Even when we're not actively trying to teach him, he's learning things and soaking everything up like a sponge. Right now he's learning to swim. He loves the water. During this quarantine, we've really been taking advantage of our pool because we're stuck at home and we take the quarantine very seriously, so we really don't go anywhere. So we spend a lot of time in our pool, and that means that our son gets a lot of playtime and we're trying to teach him how to swim. He loves the pool. It's been really fun, but it's also terrifying as a mom to like teach your son to do something as scary as swimming. So that's been fun and also a challenge. He's obviously walking. I mean, at this point, he's running practically. He can crouch down and stand back up. He loves to point to things and talk about them. He still uses sign language. He does more and please and thank you. He also likes to sing using his hands. When we do Itsy Bitsy Spider, he'll do this. Up came the sun and dried up all the rain. I do Itsy Bitsy. And the Itsy Bitsy Spider went up and spouted again.
Yay!
He's just the cutest little, coolest little guy in the whole world. He also like puts his hands on his hips when he walks around like an old man, like behind his back like this, which I think is adorable. I mean, I love that this video is supposed to be just like an update video on like the developmental stages of my son, but really it's just me talking about how I think he's really cute. As far as his personality goes, he is the sweetest, most loving, gentle soul. I can't believe that he is my son, that somehow in this universe, that perfect little soul chose to be my son and that I made him with my awesome husband. Like, he is way cooler than anyone I could have ever imagined. He's so sweet and giving. He loves to share. If he's eating a food, he has to share it with you. If he's playing with a toy, he has to share it with you. He can't enjoy anything unless there's someone that he loves next to him to share it with. Like, he just needs to share love and joy with everyone and anyone he can find. He's very, very cuddly. He loves his mama and he loves to cuddle with me. He loves to fall asleep on me. He loves to give kisses. He loves to give hugs. He hugs the cats. He hugs the dog. He hugs his family. He just hugs everyone and everything, and he's just the sweetest little guy. We're getting really close to transitioning to his very own bed. So we've always had sleep issues with our kid, and he never slept through the night. We didn't do sleep training. That was just our decision and what we wanted to do as parents. I don't judge people who do or don't. Whatever you want to do, you are the parent of your child. And as long as you're taking care of your kid and loving your kid, then you're doing it right. For us and for Flynn, it just seemed like something we didn't really want to ever do. We just didn't want to do the cry it out thing. We just weren't into that. I think because of that, Flynn does have a harder time falling asleep, and that's just the choice we made as a family and knowing that, but it's okay because it means that he really does like to cuddle and fall asleep cuddling, and I love that and Eric loves that, so it's kind of a win-win for all of us.
But
it is getting to a point where I think we're gonna get him a race car bed pretty soon. I think he's ready for it. Moms out there, please, I would love your advice and your wisdom on transitioning into a big boy bed. I just don't know if he's gonna be scared of a race car bed or if it's gonna be weird to have like a different mattress and different pillows, or I'm just kind of, it scares me a little bit. I'm curious if you guys have any advice on how that transition should go. We are seeing the beginning signs of tantrums. I mean, very early signs, and everyone warns you about the terrible twos and toddlers and how difficult they are, and so we are anticipating that stage of life to come. There have been a couple times where he has done the noodle, is what we call it, where his arms go limp, so when you try to pick him up when he's crying, you go and noodles down. We have experienced a couple of noodles. We are looking forward to the toddler phase because we know it's a big like learning time for them. They get to learn feelings and emotions and how to express themselves, and that's something I'm actually really excited to teach him. I know it will be difficult. I know toddler phase is very hard, but I'm excited to teach my little boy how to express his feelings and explain to me why he's angry or hurt or sad or scared or happy or any emotion he's feeling. I'm excited to teach him how to explain those feelings to me and that it's okay to have those feelings, but we don't noodle we talk about it. So I'm excited for him to get a little older so we can have those conversations. But yeah, we're seeing the beginning signs of toddlerhood. All right, so breastfeeding. Yes, I still breastfeed my son. This is a very touchy subject. Whenever breastfeeding is brought up, I feel like everyone just decides like,
oh, breastfeeding, let's fight. I wanna fight about this.
I don't know why you or anyone would have an opinion on how I feed my son if it's healthy and good for him. But I guess a lot of you have opinions about that. I breastfed my son and still breastfeed my son, and I love breastfeeding. I have always liked it, but I also love and am very supportive of formula. We have used formula for Flynn in the past, and I love when moms use formula. I love when moms breastfeed. Just feed your kid. That's what's important, is you feed your kid. Flynn breastfeeds at night and that is it, and he doesn't even really do it every night. He just kind of does it when he wants to. Sometimes he drinks a lot of milk and sometimes he just wants a taste and moves on. He's very much in the phase of ending breastfeeding, which is great for me. I love it, but I think I'm ready to just have my body back and let it be my body and not share it with him. That sounds weird, I phrased that weird, but you know what I'm saying. I know that my breast milk is the best thing for him. It's full of so many vitamins and nutrients and just so many wonderful things for him to help him grow and be strong. And just because of this pandemic and everything that's going on, I just want him to be as healthy as possible. Eric and I talked about it and we're like, let's just keep breastfeeding him until he decides he's done. And he's getting to that point. He's pretty much done. It's just at night, sometimes he wants some milk. I am still breastfeeding. However, not that any of you care, but I only do this side, not this side. And I've always produced way more milk on the right side than the left side for some reason, like since he was born. I think it was because right after he was born, I got like a clogged milk duct or something on this mamma jamma, and it hurt so bad. So the first couple weeks of breastfeeding, this side was much more comfortable to breastfeed on, and this side, like, literally had to claw my husband and dig my nails into his skin just so I wouldn't scream. Like, I would do this and I would cover my mouth and tears would be streaming down my face as my son breastfed on this side. It was extremely painful for like a week, and then it went away. I think that because it was so painful, I breastfed way more on this side, that it just made my milk production off or something. Maybe I'm totally wrong. I'm not a scientist, girl. I don't know how that works, but I've always thought that. So maybe I'm just making that up in my head. However, this side is completely stopped producing milk, and this side is the only side you can get some of that yummy juice from. That's why this is just a weird conversation. That's very common that happens with women who are breastfeeding. But it does mean that this side, when it's full, is significantly bigger than this side. And so that's fun, finding bras that work. But he doesn't just breastfeed, obviously. He eats all types of food. He basically eats everything at this point. He loves to eat. His favorite food is popsicles. We make him popsicles and he loves his popsicles. But he's just the coolest kid in the whole world. And I thought since he's a year and a half, it might be a good time to do another little update, even though I do them all the freaking time and I know you guys are sick of them. He is just the coolest. He loves bubbles and bouncy balls and he loves peekaboo books and he loves little puzzles. He obviously loves anything with wheels, anything he can push around. He loves to play peekaboo. He loves to sing songs. He just kind of loves life. And it's been really wonderful loving life with him. The world has been very dark and sad and scary, especially recently. There is obviously COVID-19 has been going on. Politics have been scary. And then recently with the Black Lives Matter movement, which is so important, we all need to continue to speak up and speak out against racism and do everything that we can to help end racism in our country. But with that, there have been lots of scary things that have come up. Police brutality and the violence and terror in this country against the Black community and kind of against this whole movement. I can't even begin to tell you how grateful I am for my son, because when my heart is just breaking so much for our country and for other people, Flynn will get excited about a squirrel. It feels like he puts a band-aid on my heart whenever it's breaking. He'll get excited about a gopher in a gopher hole or the bark on a tree. He'll knock a toy down and laugh so hard it seems like he's gonna choke on his laugh. laughter, all these little things just make me so happy and grateful that he's in my life to remind me that everything's gonna be okay and that life can be really hard, but there can be really, really beautiful moments too. I talked a lot in this video about how I'm excited to teach him this and teach him that, but the fact of the matter is he teaches me most days. He teaches me to take it easy and to find joy in little things like wind or bubbles. He teaches me to take a breath when I'm stressed out or to close my eyes and relax when I'm tired. And he teaches me that sometimes you just need a hug. Like when you're a mess, you just need a hug or a little kiss from your little cute baby. I'm really grateful for him. He's the best thing that has ever happened to me, and he's the coolest guy in the world. And I promise I won't give you more like monthly updates from now on. I'll give you one when he turns two. You know, obviously if you watch my vlogs, you'll be updated. I do vlog every single day. So if you want daily updates, you can go check that out. But I'm done with the baby updates till he turns two, okay? Don't come for me. I just really like these videos. I hope you guys like this video. If you did, make sure to give it a like, subscribe to my channel, follow me on my social medias, and that's all I have for you today. Stay safe, stay kind, and I will see you next time. Bye.